This is the story of the Voronezh UFO incident. Hi everyone, what's up? I am DoseGeek. It's nice to be back here with you on Section 51 in a new video. And thank you again for your support to the channel. As usual, thank you for liking, sharing and reacting to our videos. Big thanks to our explorers, navigators and commanders. The Voronezh UFO incident was an alleged UFO sighting reported in Voronezh, Soviet Union on September the 27th of 1989, a city some 300 miles southeast of Moscow. The incident was allegedly witnessed by a group of children with other members of the local community, including civil servants, claiming to have seen the craft only. The story reported by the Telegraph Agency of the Soviet Union, the TASS, claimed that a group of children had spotted a small ball in the park whilst playing, now called Yuzhny Park, which quickly morphed into a disc, which landed near them. More precisely, two boys and a girl from a local school, Vasya Surin, Zenia Blinov and Yulia Sholokova were playing in the park of the warm evening of September 27th when suddenly, at 6:30, they saw a pink shining in the sky and then spotted a ball of deep red color about 10 yards in diameter. A crowd gathered and they could clearly see a hatch opening in the lower part of the ball and a humanoid in the opening. Witnesses then reported a three-eyed alien and a robot exiting the craft. In fact, the three-eyed creature, about 9 feet tall and fashionably dressed in silvery overalls and bronze boots and with a disc on its chest, disappeared, then landed and came out for a promenade with a companion and a robot. The aliens seemed to communicate with each other, producing the mysterious appearance of a shining triangle and activated the robot with a touch. The alien stared at a horrified onlooker, freezing them in their tracks before departing and returning 5 minutes later to abduct a 16-year-old boy using what was described as a 50-centimeter long pistol tube. Though the children were the only ones claiming to have witnessed the aliens, Lieutenant Sergei A. Matveyev of the Voronezh District Police Station claimed to have seen the craft. The Interior Ministry said they would dispatch troops to the area should the craft reappear. On September 17th of 1989, TASS reported that a correspondent had spoken to 10 or 12 youths who claimed to have seen a flying saucer. The original article quoted Dr. Silanov of the Voronezh Geophysical Laboratory as confirming the location of the landing using biolocation. Silanov denied that he had ever made such a remark or carried out such an experiment. The report was the most publicized of a series of UFO claims made by official government media and were promoted as part of the government's new openness. It was noted that, unlike in America, the reported beings were completely apolitical and did not even speak during their visit. In the immediate aftermath of the alleged incident, hundreds of UFO reports began appearing, with a reporter from Komsomolskaya Pravda even claiming to have an exclusive interview with alien beings from Red Star. To this end, The Soviet Scientific Commission ordered an official inquiry into the alleged incident. Though the area was found to have an above-average presence of the radioactive isotope cesium, the vice-rector of the University of Voronezh quickly dispensed with the idea that this was significant. In the immediate aftermath of the supposed event, only Sovietskaya Kultura and TASS attempted to pass the story off as non-fiction with the official communist newspaper defending its decision, saying
its coverage was motivated by the golden rule of journalism. The reader must know everything.
The newspaper was repeatedly asked whether the report was in jest and were repeatedly assured it was not. The description of the incident was very similar to stories that appeared in the American magazine Saga, but TASS reporters stated that the witnesses probably haven't read it. Outside of print media, the US show A Current Affair also sent a crew to report on the alleged event. It was not an optical illusion, said Lieutenant Sergei Amadveyev of the Voronezh District Police Station, who said in a telephone interview that he saw the landing of the UFO in 1989. Lieutenant Matveyev confessed that he had not actually seen the aliens, but said he saw the spaceship and it was certainly a body flying in the sky, moving noiselessly at a very high speed and very low altitude. Lieutenant Matveyev said he was a little skeptical himself when he first saw the object.
I thought I must be really tired, but I rubbed my eyes and it didn't go away. Then I figured, in this day and age, anything is possible.
However, Vladimir A. Moiseyev, director of the Regional Health Department, said in a telephone interview that despite reports of widespread fear in the city, none of the witnesses had applied for medical help. But he said that,
certainly we are planning to examine the children.
There was no explanation why, with the passing of 2 weeks, such an examination had not yet taken place. In a latest development not yet reported by TASS, investigator Mr. Lebedev said that Generic M. Silanov, head of the Voronezh Geophysical Laboratory, asked the children to draw what they had seen, and drawings were similar. Tough isolated from one another, the children all drew a banana-shaped object that left behind in the sky the sign of the letter X. Such descriptions were reported as typical of UFOs in a 1976 article in the now defunct American magazine Saga. Moreover, a rock that was reportedly found at the site and described as being not something found on Earth, but new studies later discovered that it was actually a form of hematite, which is found in various parts of the Soviet Union. And you, what do you think of all this? Was it a real alien encounter? Do you have more information about this subject, this experience? Is it a real story or is it just a lovely story made by the Russian newspaper, the Telegraph Agency of the Soviet Union, in order to entertain people? Or rather to spread state propaganda on the specific subject of UFOs? I would say that the more investigators and researchers, the more UFO experts working on this UFO incident we will have, the better it will be in order to know the truth in all this story. And if all this is true, what happened to the kid who was abducted by aliens? Where is his family and can these people confirm that he's still missing? So many questions and so many blurry areas remain. I hope you enjoyed this video. While waiting for the next video, you can find us on social networks, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. please like, share, subscribe, support Section 51. I'll be back really soon. Open your eyes, watch the sky, live long and prosper.